knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about T and B cell development, so let's continue and see what happens next for these adaptive immune cells. T cell development within the thymus undergoes a major developmental checkpoint in which TCR, or T cell receptor signaling, is involved. Thymocytes, which possess TCR with a very high affinity for self-peptide MHC complexes, undergo apoptosis. This process is referred to as negative selection. In contrast, those cells bearing low-affinity TCR survive, are selected for, and differentiate into mature T cells. This process is referred to as positive selection. This extremely essential step ensures that only those T cells that are self-tolerant survive, whereas self-reactive T cells are eliminated. Next, naive mature T cells exit the thymus and enter the peripheral lymphoid organs, such as the spleen and lymph nodes. Here, they get exposed to foreign peptides that are presented by the MHC molecules of antigen-presenting cells, or APCs, such as the macrophages, dendritic cells, and B cells, during an immune challenge or an infection. The TCR interacts with the antigenic peptide, after which T cells get activated, undergoing clonal expansion and differentiation to perform their effector functions. Therefore, T cell signaling is extremely important for efficient T cell development, activation, and development of overall immune tolerance. T cells are key mediators in mounting an effective and a sustained adaptive cell-mediated host immune response. These cells constantly survey the lymphoid and peripheral tissues for pathogens and antigens, such as peptides or lipids, that are prominently displayed by major histocompatibility complex molecules of other cells. T cell activation then leads to clonal expansion, and a battery of effector functions are executed. These cells can be classified broadly as either helper T cells or cytotoxic T cells. They can be differentiated based on the presence of only two cell surface markers, CD4 and CD8. CD4 plus T cells participate in the generation of antibody-producing B cells, while CD8 plus T cells directly kill infected targets. The core TCR complex consists of two TCR chains and six clusters of differentiation 3, or CD3, chains. Additionally, several other components such as coreceptors, kinases, and ligands are also associated. The human genome is known to express four TCR genes: TCR-alpha, TCR-beta, TCR-gamma, and TCR-delta, which form two distinct heterodimers. They are either TCR-alpha, TCR-beta, or TCR-gamma, TCR-delta. The majority of mature T cells express both TCR-alpha and TCR-beta isoforms, generally referred to as alpha-beta T cells. The remaining minority of T lymphocytes expresses TCR-gamma and TCR-delta isoforms, or gamma-delta T cells. CD3 transmits the TCR-triggered signal through immunoreceptor tyrosine-based activation motifs, or ITAMs, via its cytoplasmic tail. However, it is not directly involved in antigen recognition. The CD3 gamma delta epsilon chains each contain one ITAM, while the CD3 zeta chain is known to contain three. Following the TCR engagement, ITAM phosphorylation occurs by protein tyrosine kinases, or PTKs, which allow other effector molecules to interact with the TCR complex. T cell ligands are divided into two classes, MHC class 1 and MHC class 2. Human MHC1s are composed of complexes derived from the human leukocyte antigens, or HLAs, HLA-A, HLA-B, and HLA-C, and beta-2 microglobulin. MHC2s are essentially heterodimers of several HLAs, HLA-DP, HLA-DQ, and HLA-DR. T cells with alpha-beta TCRs react to foreign antigens in the form of short peptides that are bound to MHC class 1 or class 2 proteins. These TCRs are generated by somatic DNA rearrangements and random chain pairing, and hence lack predictable specificity for their ligands. Immature thymocytes are known to express both CD4 and CD8 receptors. However, fully mature functional T cells express the co-receptor molecule that possesses an MHC class specificity that matches that of the mature cell's TCR. Endogenous antigens give rise to peptide-bound MHC1, or pMHC1, molecules that can be presented on any nucleated cell and are recognized by CD8+ T cells. On the other hand, CD4+ T cells recognize antigen peptide-bound MHC2, or pMHC2, molecules that are presented by the APCs, such as B cells, macrophages, and dendritic cells. Some APCs, including DCs, sometimes also present exogenous antigens to the MHC1 receptor to activate CD8+ T cells. This process is called cross-presentation. Antigen processing and presentation is rather complex activity, so let's move forward and discuss this in more detail next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.